Well, we got another year in the books.
Yeah, we do.
Another year on the road. 2 years down.
We're 2 years old.
Yeah. Well, today we're talking about campground costs because we get asked about that a lot.
We do.
How much does it cost to live on the road?
Yeah.
And one of the biggest costs is going to be your campground costs. Mm-hmm. Unless you're one of those people who boondock a lot.
Who are exclusive.
BLM, all that stuff. We're not. Yeah. So we want to talk about, if you're staying at campgrounds, about how much you can expect to spend over the course of a year. Now, it varies depending on what part of the country you're in, what kind of campgrounds you're staying in. Mm-hmm. But just to give you an idea, we'll share with you what we did. And we'll let you know that last year at this time, we did our wrap up and we spent $8,374 total for the whole year on campground costs.
Which was lower than I expected when we did that.
Yeah, we did budget for higher than that.
Yeah.
And so that was actually pretty good, I think.
Yeah.
Considering. Mm-hmm. So we'll break it down.
We had not gotten into Thousand Trails.
Yeah, last year we were not Thousand Trails members.
Yeah.
So this year we are. And so that has helped us a little bit, mm-hmm. but we'll break it all the way down. Now, over the past year, we have had 38 different stops.
Okay.
Through 15 different states.
Not bad.
That's a lot.
Yeah.
So you figure out 38 different times and different places. So, and we went from Florida all the way up to Washington State. So
that's true, yeah.
Prices vary a lot
in different areas
of the country.
You could definitely tell a difference.
Yeah. We stayed for 16 total weeks in privately owned campgrounds, which I think if we do better at that next year, I think that price will get better. We need to stay less at private campgrounds.
Well, and because we did our I-90 caravan with friends,
yes,
that pushed us a lot into private places.
Which we treated that like a vacation.
Yeah.
So we weren't really in savings mode. We were just in convenience wherever we need to stay mode.
Yeah.
And whatever it costs, we'll pay it.
Yeah.
So for those 16 weeks total, $3,958. That was the most places that we stayed and the biggest cost.
Yeah.
Obviously. The next was 15 weeks in Thousand Trails, which cost us nothing.
Nothing.
Ha!
Zero.
I mean, we did pay for the membership.
Yeah.
It is paying itself back.
Yeah.
But in the grand scheme of things, $0 for the mm-hmm. Thousand Trails. 15 weeks. That's pretty good.
Yeah.
That's where we made up our savings, I think, total, which we'll share with you at the end of the video. We stayed 12 weeks total in military campgrounds, mm-hmm. which cost us a total of $2,540, which is pretty good for 12 weeks.
Yeah. I mean, if you compare it to the 16 weeks in private.
Yeah.
It
not bad at all.
Like $1,400 more
yes.
in the private part.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
We stayed 2 weeks at RPIs, which are affiliates of Thousand Trails. Mm-hmm. And for those 2 weeks, $165 for 2 weeks.
Yeah.
That's less than you pay for 1 week
yeah.
at a regular campground.
Exactly.
So the savings on RPI, even though we've only stayed 2 weeks, paid for itself and then some.
Yes.
Because the cost of that was $125 for the year.
Mm-hmm.
So that worked out well. And then, you know, that doesn't add up to 52 weeks. And that's because at some locations we overlapped. Like we stayed, you know, 10 days or, you know, 12 days or sometimes
yeah, it wasn't
we stayed
weekly marked.
Yeah, sometimes we stayed just an overnight stay or we stayed 3 nights at a location just to get to where we're going.
Uh-huh.
When we were in Bartow, Florida, we stayed at the parking lot of the Camping World while our Montana was being fixed. So that stuff we didn't even.
Bad memories.
So all of that's a total of 6 weeks combined.
Yeah.
And so that I just put those costs in where they belong. With private campgrounds or Thousand Trails or whatever.
Okay.
So that's already wrapped up all into it. So this year total, we spent $6,902, which compared to $8,374 last year is great.
Yeah.
We saved $1,472 from this year compared to last year. Now, a lot of that was due to Thousand Trails.
Yes.
And we would have saved way more had we, you know, not done the vacation. And
yeah.
you know, some of the places just it's so spread out here in the West that you pretty much got what you got. You're gonna pay unless you wanna drive 10 hours between stops. You're just
or
gonna pay.
You wanna boondock.
Exactly, which we don't want
which
to
which we don't.
So if you average all of that out, that was like between last year and this year, $122 per month savings.
Yeah.
Which is great.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
Not bad at all. So if you take that $6,902,
mm-hmm,
and divide it by 12, we had a monthly campground payment of $575 per month.
Which is good.
That's good. We budgeted for way more than that.
Yeah.
And I think that it's going to get...
We budgeted for almost twice that.
Yeah, and you know, between Florida and Washington, there wasn't very many opportunities for Thousand Trails stays.
No.
Which I'm hoping that this year there's going to be more. We are headed down into California,
mm-hmm,
where there's lots of Thousand Trails. We're starting off the year right.
Yeah.
I mean, we're going into Thousand Trails for like, you know, 6 or 7 weeks out of the first couple of years going into this new, what I guess we'll call our fiscal year, because we started September 1st.
Yeah.
So our year starts September 1st, and it's getting ready to be that right now.
Yeah.
So we're going directly into lots of Thousand Trail stays. So we're, mm-hmm, going to be saving money right off the bat. I don't know what that's going to look like going into the year. And just kind of, it's like I said, yeah, with these wildfires and with COVID and with potential family concerns, we don't really know where we're going to end up. And so we might find ourselves stuck in the same situation where we just have to pay what we have to pay because that's where we need to stay.
Yeah.
So I don't know. But we have stayed in a lot of great places,
mm-hmm,
and some not so great places.
Mm-hmm.
So I asked you this before off camera because I keep a spreadsheet, surprise, surprise,
big shocker,
of every place we stay, how much it costs, how long we stayed. Mm-hmm. And of course, you don't remember off the top of your head where all we stayed. So
there's too many.
I told you during this video, I'm going to ask you what your favorite stay was. And I scrolled through there, yeah. I let you look at it, but I don't know yet what it is. I just did that as a reminder for you so you wouldn't sit on camera and go, aww. So, out of the last year, what was your favorite stay?
Now that's a difficult thing because there's a lot of favorites.
Yeah.
I mean, you like a lot of stuff. I loved Wyoming.
You know, it was great.
I loved South Dakota. There's more of South Dakota I want to see. We just nicked it, but what I did see, I loved.
Yeah.
So I'm sure I'm going to love most of South Dakota. Of course, I want to get to the southern part of Florida. I know I'll love that.
Yeah, the Keys. We didn't get down there this year.
But we didn't make it there. But I would say, city-wise, overall, one of my, if I had to pick a favorite, it would be Colorado Springs.
Hey, I was going to say the same thing.
Nuh-uh.
I was.
Yeah?
Yeah, and not just the city and how much stuff there is to do there, because we were there for 2 weeks and still didn't get even close to doing everything.
No, and because a lot of that was due to COVID. Some things were still shut down that we wanted to do, so it has even way more that I'm anxious to go explore.
But on top of that, it was one of the best campgrounds that we've stayed in also.
Yes, it was.
Because we stayed at the Air Force Academy. Right there,
which is gorgeous,
in Colorado Springs.
Beautiful.
It's right
park.
Off the interstate.
Yeah,
right at the base of Pikes Peak.
Yeah,
and it's just amazing there.
It is, and I think Colorado in general is going to be high on my favorites of states.
Yeah,
because I can't wait to get to Durango area.
Yeah, we just went sides of Colorado. Straight up the middle.
I liked Denver. I just didn't like the traffic in Denver.
It was pretty crazy.
Yeah, but overall, stop-wise, Colorado Springs just was phenomenal.
Yeah, and so there you have it. Even with us not being very frugal at all, $575 a month is not terrible.
No, it's not.
But we're going to try to beat it this next year.
Uh-oh.
We're going to try to do better and better every year.
Okay.
So
Well, let's not get too crazy because I can't shift too much down into those miscellaneous of the harvest host. And the,
I think we will plateau at a certain point, but I think we can do better than 6,900.
But our summer trip was a big budget breaker there.
Yeah.
So as long as we're not doing another Midwest caravan, I think we can beat it.
Yeah. We'll see how it goes. Leave us a comment. Let us know what you're spending in campground fees. A lot of these places are harder to get into, and because they're harder to get into, the prices are going up because the demand for camping is going up. So that might put a little pinch in you too.
Yeah, that's going to play a factor too with so much shutdowns over going on 2 years. People are going to be raising their prices. So
yeah.
we might not be able to avoid getting cheaper because inflation.
Yeah. But let us know what you think. Let us know what you're paying out there, and let us know
tell
if
us
you
how
think
how well we did.
Yeah, let you let us
no,
know.
No, I know all you boondockers and harvest hosters are going to be like, "Oh, you could have saved so much more money." I know. I got it. But being the way we are, I think we fell very good.
I think so too.
Into the spending spectrum.
Yeah. We'll see how it goes next year.
Okay.
But it's fun. No telling where we're going to end up.
That's right.
We'll take you with us though. Like we do at the end of all of our videos, we're going to honor a fallen hero. If you want to get involved with helping us help vets, everything you need to know is down in the description of the video. We appreciate you watching. See you next time.
Bye. Bye.